Good afternoon, class 9. So we were doing laws of motion, and today we are going to start with the third part of laws of motion. So in the previous videos we learned about inertia. Now the Newton's first law of motion gives us two important concepts. One is the concept of inertia and the other is the concept of force. So we learned about inertia and now we are going to learn about force. Now force can be defined as, the definition of force is, force is an external agent which either changes the size and shape of the body or changes the state of rest and motion of the body. So force is an external agent which either changes the size and shape of the body or changes the state of rest or motion of the body. Now we already discussed it in the previous videos that if a ball is lying on the ground stationary, then what the force does is, if you apply a force, what it does is it gives a motion to the body. So that is one example. And another example, so the effects of force can be written as, there are two effects of force. Either it can change the size or shape of the body, or it can change the state of rest and motion of the body. The state of rest and motion of the body. Now, example wise, changing the size and shape of the body. Suppose we have a rubber ball and we apply a pressure on the rubber ball. What happens? The size and shape of the rubber ball changes. Similarly, suppose we have a spring and we attach some load with the spring. What happens? The length of the spring increases. So those are examples of how force changes the size and shape of the body. Next is the state of rest and motion, which is very easily understandable, the examples that I gave you. A ball is lying on the ground. If you don't push the ball, it will not move forward. The way a horse cart moves, the way the gravitational, because of the gravitational force, everything falls towards the earth. All of these are examples of how force changes the state of rest and motion of the body. So these are the two effects of force. Now in the size and shape part, there is one important thing to know, which is the size and shape of a body will change only if the body is not rigid. What I mean by rigid is that if the intermolecular spaces, if the interparticle spaces of the object can be changed, then the body is called non-rigid. But if the interparticle space, the intermolecular space cannot be changed in a body, that body is called rigid body. So if only if a body is non-rigid, only then the force can cause some change in size and shape of the body. Fine. So after this, we have two types of force. There are two types of forces. Forces can be of various type, but in this chapter we will divide force in two types. First is the contact force and second is the non-contact force. First is the contact force and second is the non-contact force. So as the name suggests, what are contact forces? Contact forces are forces which act only when the bodies are in physical contact with each other, when they are directly touching each other. So there has to be direct physical contact. On the other hand, non-contact forces are those which can act even if the bodies are not in direct contact to each other. In fact, they act when the bodies are not in direct contact to each other. Not in direct contact with each other. So let us see some examples of both types. Let us see some examples of both types of pose. First is the contact pose. One example of this is frictional force or friction force. What is friction force? Suppose we have a surface on which there is a body which is moving forward. Okay. Now there will be a force acting in the opposite direction to the motion of the body. There will be a force, if this is the direction of motion of the body, there will be a force acting in the opposite direction to the motion of the body, which is called the frictional force. This force arises because of the sliding of this body over the surface. This body is in contact with this surface and the body is sliding over this surface. This gives rise to a force in the opposite direction, which is known as the frictional force. So this frictional force is a contact force. This would not have come into play if the body and the surface were not in contact with each other. So frictional force is one. Secondly, we have normal reaction force. Normal reaction force. About this force you will learn more in the third law of Newton. But if I just give you a brief idea. So if a body is lying on a surface, one force acts in the downward direction, which is the weight of the body. The weight of the body acts in the downward direction. Now another force acts in the upward direction, which is the force that the surface applies on the body, which acts in the upward direction. This is the normal reaction force. This is a force which acts in the upward direction, and it only comes into play when the body is lying on the surface. So this is the normal reaction force, which is another contact force. Next we have tension force. Tension force. What is tension force? Suppose you have a string which has a mass attached to its end. Now this mass will obviously draw the string, will drag the string in the downward direction because of its weight. The string will be dragged in the downward direction because of the weight of the body. As a result of this, another force will act in the upward direction, which is known as the tension force. So the upward force which acts on the string when the string is hung with some weight, that is known as tension force. This is also a contact force. Similarly, we have of the force due to a spring. We have the force due to a spring. So suppose we have a spring like this and we have a mass attached to the spring. Okay. So when this spring is stretched, there will be a force acting in the opposite direction, which is known as the restoring force. Alright, so this is also a contact force. So these are basically the important contact forces. We have friction, we have normal reaction, we have tension, and we have restoring force. So these are the contact forces. Now let us see some non-contact forces. So next is non-contact force. First example of this is gravitational force. What is gravitational force? The force with which every object attracts every other object on this earth because of their masses, that is known as the gravitational force. This gravitational force does not need the bodies to be in direct touch with each other. Even if the bodies are far apart from each other, the gravitational force will act between them. So gravitational force is one non-contact force. Another non-contact force is electrostatic force. Electrostatic force. When we have got two charges, suppose we have one like one plus and one plus charge, two plus charges, what will happen? They will repel each other. Similarly, if we have one plus and one minus force, what will happen? They will attract each other. So this repulsion, this attraction, all of these have a force. So this force of attraction or repulsion between two charges, either to like charges or to unlike charges. This is known as electrostatic force, and this force also does not need the charges to be in direct contact with each other. Even if the charges are separated from each other, they will act. So this is electrostatic force. Another force is magnetic force. Magnetic force is also a non-contact force. The force with which two poles of a magnet, if one is a north pole and another is a south pole, they attract each other, or two north poles and two south poles repel each other, these are known as the magnetic forces, and they also act without the magnets being in direct touch with each other. That is, they are non-contact forces. So these are some examples. One is gravitational force, one is electrostatic force, and one is magnetic force. Gravitational force is only attractive in nature. Gravitational force never repels anything. Everything is attractive. Electrostatic and magnetic force can be both attractive and repulsive. If two like charges are present or two like poles are present, then repulsion happens. If two unlike charges are present or unlike poles are present, then attraction happens. So there is another important property of the non-contact forces, which is that the non-contact forces are dependent on the distance of separation between the two bodies. If we are talking about gravitational force, how far apart the two bodies are situated from each other, that depends, that affects the magnitude of the force. The magnitude of the force, or how strong the force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. The force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. That means if you increase the distance between them, the force will obviously decrease. Okay, so if the distance between them is doubled, the force will become 1/4. Okay, so this is known as the inverse square law, and this is followed by these non-contact forces. So this is everything about contact and non-contact forces and the general idea of force. From the next video, we will start with the second law of Newtonian mechanics, or Newton's second law.